It's 84 years contribution than 100 years of Indian cinema. The Kapoors have been. My grandfather first appeared in a film in sometime 28 or 29, silent era period. We made 91 films, 91 silent films before we made Alamara, which was in 34, 35. My grandfather was one of the character actors. He wasn't the lead. Master Vittal was. And so I'm just reminded, I must tell you that this is a reflection, not mine. Remembering, I'm piecing, you know, whatever my father has said earlier to me. And when I was told to speak on this occasion, so I gathered, and I don't want to bore you, but I just must tell you about it, that, you know, in my grandfather's time, films were made, produced by institutions, you know, New Theatre, everybody. So every actor was employed. You used to get a monthly stipend. There was nothing called, you know, whatever you, actors as of today, what they get a price. So there was no problem that the picture was going to go, not going to go, we had our money. So it was an independent kind of thing. And in those days, very early days, we used to make mythologicals. We only made mythologicals. I don't know for what reason, but we made only mythologicals. That trend changed, as Haveeb rightly said, that when India got its independence, we were a young budding nation. So we had a lot of problems. The youth had a lot of problems. They were searching, soul searching. We didn't know what to do. That's what my father said. We had a lot of subjects. Shantaramji made a lot of great films. Mehboob. A lot of people were writing. There were things. That's why you talk about Avara, Shri Chaat Subhi. You talk about several other filmmakers' films. Because there were problems. So Raj Kapoor and his colleagues went through that period. Then, as like Haveeb rightly said, it transformed into when I became an actor. Now, I'm talking about my father, my grandfather, my father, myself, and I'll go on to Ranbir. When I came in, the audiences were very forgiving. At any given point of time, every actor, every colleague of mine had 3 to 4 minimum films based on Lost and Found. That was the safest thing to do. Every actor, and the audience was very forgiving. They used to watch the films also and make big heroes out of their actors also. But nowadays, like I feel when Ranbir works, or the today's directors work, it's so competitive. You have the internet, you have, there's so much of information available freely to you. You're competing with the television, films made in the West, everything is available on through via cable to your house. So you are very, you're in a competitive world. So it's like, you know, you got to be delivered the best. So cinema has changed over the years, as I see in my family, you know, over the years. Now, I'm part of this trend, so it gives me an opportunity. I don't think in my, when I became, let's say, a leading actor, senior actors of those days had an opportunity to work in what today I have. I think this is happening mainly because, I would say, they call it the multiplex culture. When I say multiplex culture, you know, people who go to a multiplex pay 200, 250 rupees a ticket. Now, that's not perhaps the, you know, the rate of probably an auto fare while I can do. That means we are making films according to the sensibilities of people who are educated who can afford to see films. So thereby, when we used to make film for front benches, bolte the Bihar, UP, ke liye picture banani, unke liye banani. I mean, for some reasons, that is getting eradicated, or either probably we are moving forward. I do not know. His film is an proof in point. I had never even really thought that his film would cross 100 crore mark. But Barfi has done that.
Neither did I, sir.
So, you know, I'm just saying how things have changed. A film like Oh My God, a film which doesn't boast of a great star cast, has a good actor who takes content forward. So these are the welcoming signs I see, that films are doing great business because they're good films. And as rightly said, good films will always survive.